What's up? Y'all know I'm not Trey, right? This is my love. This is. I love you too. What's up? Hey, listen, man. My name is Terrence J. I'm so happy to. Love. I love y'all. Listen, I don't have to go into the accomplishments of these two gentlemen that are gonna hit the stage, because we can talk records, we can talk tours, we can talk movies, we can talk all of that. What I wanna say is, for both of them, and I've known both of them for years and years and years, the amount of attention to detail, the amount of effort and hard work that these guys put into their craft, these guys love you guys, their fans, like nobody's business. So what we're doing something right now is something very intimate, something special. This is for the super fans only. Do we have any super fans in the building? All right. So I want y'all to keep that momentum going for my brother from another mother. Make some noise for Trey Songz.
You can see who's in it. Oh, and if we're talking about sex, girl, you know, girl, you know that I've been at that. Hey, and I'm on to the next. That's unless you bring a friend who with it. Oh, hey, I'm sorry. Oh, you mad that I came to the party? Like,
no, no,
huh? You took your girl to the club and now she gone. Now she asking me when I'm taking her home. I told her, let's go. Long as you know, cause I know when we get along.
I'm touching
you tonight. What's up? I'm loving you tonight. Wait, no, I'm crushing you, girl. You must be used to spending, putting in that time. Touching, loving, crushing. While I'm deep up in it, oh, if they living right next, then I bet they know my name in a minute. What? It's true. Let me feel your body sweat. I promise I'll keep your body dripping. Oh, I'm sorry. Niggas mad that I came to the party. Like, no, no, no. Took your girl to the club and now she gone, gone, gone. Now she asking me when I'm taking her home.
Time I'm legit. Oh, nigga, that's that nerve. You all about her and she
nigga, won't you?
And what?
And your nigga can't do nothing for you.
What they say?
Took us to the bay with me. The white girls like Lady Gaga. Rolling up that Bob Marley, I'm a rock star. She wanna do drugs. Smoke weed, get drunk. She wanna see a nigga trap.
Hey.
She wanna fuck all the rappers.
I'm a rich nigga, won't you, baby? And your nigga can't do nothing for you. Nothing, oh.
Let's get to it.
Right away.
We up in this club, bring me the bottle. I know, girl, that you came in this bitch with your man. That's a no-no, girl. All this money in the air, I wanna see you next. Just got rich.
What?
Took a broke bitch. I can make a broke bitch rich.
For what? For what?
She gon' cheat.
Yeah.
Come on, girl, why you frontin'? Baby, show me something.
But you done spent your bread on her.
And it's all for nothing.
Yeah. Rich nigga, won't you? Won't you, baby?
Yes, sir. You think we should do one together?
I got the club going up. Got your girl in the cut and she chooses. Club going up.
On a Tuesday.
On a Tuesday.
Got your girl.
Your club going up.
Hey. Let me get you.
Trapping at the bando. Put a bride on the
For this tour, we just wanted to put something together special for y'all so we can announce it and let everybody come out and have fun.
Y'all got initial access. Y'all the first people to hear this message. Y'all the only people here for this building and here hearing this announcement. If y'all looking forward to the tour like we looking for the tour, then make some motherfucking noise.
Yeah. Oh man.
Guys, give it a one time. Chris Brown, Trey Songz.
First of all, thank you so much to everybody here. We got a lot of people at home as well. Thank you so much for tuning in to the live stream. LiveNation.com. It's on and popping right now. Man. So, gentlemen, wow. This feels good to be here. Gentlemen, take me back to the inception of this tour. Two megastars, Trey Songz and Chris Brown. How did that phone call go when you guys decided, listen, man, we want to give the people something special?
It was real easy, actually. Like, you want to go on tour? He was like, yeah, you want to do it? And the next thing I knew, we was on Instagram talking back and forth about it, you know, getting the fans excited. You know, for me, 2005 was the year that both of us came into the game, and you know, it was very special for both of us because in the beginning of our careers, we were actually on a tour together, and that was my first tour. Is your first tour too?
Yeah, we did it like
free college tour.
Yeah,
and you know, 10 years later, next year, it just feels like the right thing to do.
It's unbelievable. 2005 is when I first started at BET. I remember that tour because, you know, you guys were out. So you guys have known each other for quite some time. You're both from VA, and the tour kicks off in VA. How does it feel to represent and put on for your state across the world the way you guys do? How does it feel to rep VA and be able to go out on tour together repping VA?
I mean, well, for us, I can speak with Trey too at the same time, because both of us being from Virginia, being able to have an opportunity to do music and, you know, something we continuously love is great. You know, I think as far as like every artist that comes from Virginia, whether it's me, him, you know, Missy, Timbaland, Pharrell, you know, it's very rare. you know, where we're from to be able to get that opportunity to do what we do. So, for sure. Yeah. You know, so us being able to do that, you know, it's just great to be able to go around the world and kind of, you know, have an understanding because we're from the same area. You know, being able to touch many lives around the world. So it's just great, man.
This looked like a lot of fun. Are you guys having fun? It looks like it's a lot of fun being on stage together.
Of course. It's funny, though, because as many appearances and, like, impromptu shows we've done over the last, like, what, month and a half, 2 months,
yeah.
It's never been a rehearsal. It's never been us. You know, it's just outside of us being in the studio and us being friends and knowing each other's energy, like, it's amazing just to get on stage and be able to just perform like that at whim. He know my songs. I know his. It's just dope.
What's the vibe like when you guys are in the studio? So when you come up with a song and you do the remix to Tuesday, how does that creative process begin? I mean, do you guys just throw ideas at each other and it just manifests in there?
Kind of. You know, usually when people, you know, working with him in the past and just being able to see certain different artists, how they work in the studio, we kind of are rare because we go in the studio and we can just sit in the booth and listen to the music and come up as we go along, you know. So me and him actually both sat in the booth together recording those songs, had two microphones set up, and just was going back and forth off, you know, of ideas and stuff, so, you know.
And you guys, I mean, everybody knows, it's no play pretend. You guys are friends in real life.
Yeah.
How important is it to have a brother in the industry, somebody that you can call when you're going through rough times, that you can say, listen, man, I need somebody to talk to. I'm going through this. I'm going through that. How important is it to have that camaraderie?
I mean, Chris, my dog. He my dog. Like, everybody know that from the beginning of my career. He's probably one of the most heavily scrutinized artists in the history of music thus far. You know, everybody make mistakes, and I think, you know, a lot of people saw how real it was like a year ago when I went to court for him, and that was nothing for me. Like, that's my dog. Like, outside of music, outside of the celebrity, all that. You know, because people go through a lot of crazy things in this game, and he could speak to the testament of how real that is. So to have, I just let him know as much as I can that, my nigga, I'm here for you regardless of what the world thinks about you.
Chris, what do you love most about Trey?
Honestly, like, being from where we from, man, like, you don't really get a chance to have friends that understand what you go through or understand real country shit, you know what I'm saying? So, like, I feel like me and him understand that the most, because where we from and the area we from is just real. Like, it's not, you know, ain't no sugarcoating. Some people don't even know certain people that's in it. You might go to the store and be like, who the hell is you? Like, so, you know, being able to have that same camaraderie and you know, just being able to understand one another and just him being a friend, like, at the end of the day, regardless if we singing or we on stage or on tour, like, we still can kick it. We can go play basketball. We can go just be homies, you know what I'm saying? So it's rare to find certain people, and it's only about a handful of people I can honestly call my real friends in the industry, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I think we got a lot of real friends in the building right now. What we're going to do is, Trav, let me get that piece of paper. Trav, hear me that? All right, we got some questions from fans at home on Twitter that have been hitting us, so we'll jump into some of these.
Shout out to everybody watching home, wherever you at in the world.
Yeah.
Make some noise for the people that's not here right now, the people that's watching.
All right, Manuel Cav wants to know, what songs off the new albums are you both looking forward to performing?
All right. There's so many songs.
You nasty as hell. One of y'all. What she say? They just nasty. Trey, they just nasty.
What she say, bro?
I'm trying to something with her panties, and I don't know what.
She said something about her panties.
Just something nasty, man. It's nothing. Nasty.
I might sing Panty Dropper. That's off an old album. But, you know, it's a lot of hits on both albums. I think it just, God lined it up so perfect, man, that our albums came out, you know, within a short amount of time of one another. And I'm looking forward to performing a lot of songs like Cake, All We Do, Touch and Loving, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, you know, because we got to make sure we do a tour that's going, and a show that's going to be long and lengthy for, you know, because only a couple of acts on the show. So when we do it, when we come out, we're going to make sure we do at least a 2-hour show. You know what I'm saying? So both of us can actually combine all of our hits over the times and also the new stuff from the album. His album, he got a amount of hits on it, crazy. You know, so on my album, I got a chance to showcase all the ones that I do too. So we're gonna just put it together.
And I love that. So if you're at home and you're wondering, not all just the new material, they're gonna drop some joints from the classic vaults as well. All right. Benny M. Pieto wants to, I don't know if I said your name wrong, all right? I probably messed up your name. Wants to know, what is the most fun, what do you think will be the most fun part of touring together?
Well, I mean, when you're on tour, it's a plethora of things that makes the tour, you know what I'm saying? Being on stage is one main, that's the priority right there, but after parties, you know.
Any pranks? Who's the prankster out of you two?
Of course we're going to do that. You know, we got a large amount of entourage and friends that travel with us, so.
I think that's actually going to be one of the best parts of the tour. Yeah. Like, because, you know, his team get along with my team, and they really the energy behind us that keep us going. You know what I mean? On the days when, you know, you might not want to work, you might not want to give it your all, you got people behind you on his side as well as my side that's just going to make it a great vibe. And I think, you know, backstage may be one of the best parts of the tour, actually.
I'm sure Kevin Lyles and Ro will have a camera there. Mike G, someone have a camera filming that backstage
stuff. It's always
stuff.
Rolling. Camera always rolling, man.
All right. this comes from Celebrity Trey Minaj. Oh, what? I don't even know how to say your name, okay? Your name, your Twitter name is Chris. What is that? Chris Trey Minaj? All right. All right, when did you guys really know you wanted to go on tour together? I think they answered that earlier. And then Lorraine 828 wants to know, Chris, what's your most personal song on the X album and why?
Most personal song on the X album? It depends, because a lot of the songs, I got a real chance to just write and compose and come up with different ideas of what I was going through at different times. So I would probably say maybe, you know, Do Better or Autumn Leaves.
You?
Most personal song on my album? I Know. It's a song called I Know.
So listen, guys, if you're at home right now, thanks again for tuning in and checking us out. So the tour, it kicks off this January. Tell them anything else they should know about the tour, guys.
Get your tickets.
Yeah.
When do tickets go on sale?
In 2 days.
2 days. So is anybody in here going to cop some tickets for this tour?
In Virginia, January 30th, we coming to Virginia. So we touch
day
at
home.
First day on tour. Two up, two down.
And before we get to that, so any holiday plans, gentlemen, before I let you go?
Holiday plans. My birthday is actually Black Friday.
Nice. I'm turning 30, baby.
So what I've been doing all month is I actually been doing, shout out to all the angels in here, shout out to Team Breezy. What I've been doing all month is something I'm calling 30 for 30 with 30 random acts of kindness. And that's anything small, anything large, whatever you can do to give back is something that my fans could do for my birthday, and it's something I've been doing the whole month. It's a great feeling.
I absolutely love that. Guys, when you see them come out on stage and they perform for the 3 or 5 minutes, just know that hours and hours and hours of preparation, working on their craft, mastering what they do goes into it. These two love to perform. They're gonna go on stage and give the most amazing tour of the new year. I can put my money on that, all right? So what I want y'all to do is, if you're at home right now on LiveNation.com, go purchase your tickets. They're available in 2 days. You better go ahead and buy them before they sell out. And I want everybody here in the building to make some noise and give it up for Trey Songz and Chris Love at the Breezy.
Thank y'all.
Appreciate it. Love y'all, man. Appreciate it, for real.
Thank y'all so much.
In the bedroom, devil in the skin tight.